Welcome to this video learning series right here on YouTube, QuickBooks Online for Landlords. This playlist will give all landlords everything they need when using QuickBooks Online. This is the first in the video playlist, and we will learn in this video what rental property owners need when keeping records using QuickBooks Online. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. This playlist is a video series that will give everything a landlord or rental property owner or property manager, everything they may need when keeping financial real estate records using QuickBooks Online. You can follow the videos in order of this playlist step by step, and then you will be an expert by the time you finish. You can purchase the whole course and own the videos forever and get good service for support with your property records by going to the website QuickBooksForLandlords.net. Now, what is this particular video? Well, this video that you're watching now is an overview of what unique challenges there are when keeping financial records of real estate property and rentals as compared to the way a normal company would use QuickBooks Online. You will get advice on how to get the QuickBooks Online software for free, and we will discuss preparing how you can use the rest of the videos in this playlist so you can master and use QuickBooks Online for your rental property management. What records do landlords need to keep that most other companies do not need to keep? Well, we must record rent payments from tenants that pay for future time staying in the rental unit. Therefore, we must receive these payments before we earn them. They must be recorded as unearned income at the moment we receive the tenant's money. We must change the category of the tenant's payments we received from unearned income to earned income as the tenant continues to stay in the rental unit over time. We must give a rent receipt to a tenant that will acknowledge the tenant's payment. We must keep records of the tenant's security deposit balances and keep them separate from the tenant's records of the normal rent balances. We must apply the deposits to expenses that the tenant causes, and we must give the tenant a paid receipt for those applied security deposit expenses. We must issue a refund check for the remaining unused security deposit and a refund check for any unused rent. We must be able to track income and expense by apartment. And if you flip property, you must be able to verify mortgage calculations for interest and principal amounts. You must categorize each mortgage payment between interest, principal, and escrow amounts. And you must track cost of upgrades to the property separately from the normal monthly expenses. You must calculate and record the profit and loss from the sale of the flipped property. And you have to manage and track progress on lease contracts and keep separate records of those as well. There are a variety of other tenant transactions for the many different arrangements that one could have with the tenants. And we will have a video for the most common ones so that we can be prepared for almost any situation while keeping records as a landlord using QuickBooks Online. I always try to help my students get the QuickBooks Online software for free when learning a video course in QuickBooks Online. That's why the first three videos that follow in this playlist are from the other QuickBooks Online courses. So please be patient and flexible. They will still show you options on how to create a free account so that you can use the free account for your education when studying QuickBooks Online. The next video that immediately follows this one will show you how to sign up for free for the Accountant's Edition of QuickBooks Online. The video after that one will show you how you can join with the QuickBooks Online Plus version and get a 30-day free trial if that's how you would like to do this course. And the third video that follows this one will help you prepare for sudden, unexpected changes to your QuickBooks Online software that happen all the time. I wish you good luck in your studies, and of course, you can always ask me a question in the comments section below, and I hope you enjoy the course, and I know you will learn well.